Hello students, in the previous class we have observed about the classification of amino acids. So today I am going to discuss you about the proteins. So generally in the previous class I have told you that proteins is nothing but amino acids which consist of peptide linkages. Okay, so here what we can say here, proteins are naturally occurring amino acids. We can say proteins are what here? Naturally occurring polypeptides. Polypeptides containing more than 100 amino acid units. This one we call it as what here? This one we call it as proteins. So here we are having the linkage, polypeptide linkage with the combination of amino acids. If you take COOH, CH2, NH2 you are taking. For this again you are taking NH2, CH, CH3, COOH. Okay, so here what happens, here H molecule, here OH, so there will be a loss of water molecule is going to take place. So it is forming what here? NH2, CH2, CO, NH, CH, CH3, COOH. Okay, so this linkage we call it at what here? CONH linkage, we call it as peptide linkage. Okay, so this is nothing but peptide linkage we are having here. So it consists of dipeptide, tripeptide and also polypeptides also. If more than 10 it is having, that we call it as polypeptide. Already we have discussed. Okay, so generally it is mainly occurring what? These proteins are occurring here, wool, nail, skin, hair, silk, okay, tissues, hormones and enzymes. Okay, so these are the things it is mainly occurring in proteins, generally hormones. So when you take enzymes, what will happen? They will give biochemical reactions. When you take hormones, they will give metabolic reactions. So has antibodies, they protect the body against the toxic substances. Okay, so this is nothing but proteins. So what are proteins? What we can say, what are enzymes? We can say here, so here the enzyme is nothing but enzymes, they catalyze biochemical reactions. Biochemical reactions. Coming to hormones, hormones they regulate metabolic activities. Metabolic reactions, antibodies protect the body against toxic substances. Okay, so means what we can say here, this is generally enzymes, antibodies, hormones. I have told you biochemical reactions is nothing but what here? About plants we can say. Hormones means what here? Hormones will be present in the metabolic reactions. Metabolic reactions means it consisting of different types of activities. Antibodies means what here? From poisonous substances it will protect our body. Okay, so coming to here, I have told you more than 10 amino acids means 100 amino acid units which is having molecular weight 10,000. What are proteins? By this definition what we can say here, the polypeptide with, poly means more than 10 amino acid units, we call it as polypeptide. So here what we can say, the polypeptide with more than 100 amino acid residues having molecular mass higher than 10,000 units, we call it as a protein. So means what here, protein means what we can say here, protein is nothing but which is having more than 100 amino acids, which is having molecular mass, molecular weight 10,000 microns, we call it as what here, protein. So here the distance between polypeptide and protein is not very sharp. Polypeptide with less amino acids are called proteins. If they have well defined conformation of proteins, we call it as insulin, which contain 51 amino acids. So this is general introduction. So these are generally divided into two types, that is, first one is globular proteins, and second one is fibrous proteins. So these are the two types it has divided. So now let us see about globular proteins. Let us see fibrous proteins first of all. So here fibrous protein is nothing but what means, when the polypeptide chain you have been taken. So here when you take polypeptide chain, so what will happen, it will run parallelly, okay, and together by hydrogen and disulfide bonds. It is like fiber like structure, that's why we call it as this one as a fibrous proteins. So here when you take these proteins, it is insoluble in water. So there are some examples like keratin, so which will be present in hair, wool, silk, and myosin, which will be present in muscles. So what we can say here, fibrous protein is nothing but what, when the polypeptide chains run parallel and held together by hydrogen and sulfide rings, bonds. So means what here, when chained and parallel, which is together by hydrogen and disulfide bonds, then the fiber like structure is formed, we can say. So this one is what here, which is insoluble in water. So means what here, if you take hydrogen sulfide, okay, so like this it is going to linkage, so like parallelly it is going, okay. So here example we can take it as keratin. So keratin is nothing but here, it mainly present in hair, wool, silk. And coming to next example, if you have been taken myosin, so which will be present in muscles. Okay, so this is nothing but the fibrous proteins. So coming to next one, what we are going to have, globular proteins we are having. So coming to globular proteins is nothing but here, when the chains of polypeptide, so here it will coil like this, like a spring type, okay. So this one we call it as globular proteins. Polypeptide chain coils around a to give a spherical shape, which will give a spherical shape. There is a soluble in water. Here examples will be insulin, albumin. Albumin is nothing but in egg white we are going to have, okay. So what is globular proteins, we can say here, the chains of polypeptide coil. Around to give a spherical shape which is soluble in water, we call it as what here? Globular protein. So example what we can take here, so example we can take here insulin and albumin. So these are the examples of the globular proteins. Okay, so these are the two types, fibrous proteins and globular proteins. So generally we are having, let us see about structure of proteins. So generally structure of proteins is mainly consist of peptide bonds only here. So what is our next topic? Structure of proteins. So structure of proteins is nothing but what here? This structure will be different levels, means in proteins the amino acids are linked by peptide and SH bonds. So they are hydrophobic interactions, hydrogen bonding, ionic bonding. So here the shapes, mainly we are going to study the mainly shapes. Okay, so depending upon that we are going to have four types, that is primary structure, so first one is what here, primary structure we are going to have. So in primary structure what happens means it is a sequence, the orderly it is arranged. Okay, the amino acids are arranged in sequence, so that one we call it as what here, primary structure. Okay, the sequence in which amino acids are arranged in protein, and also here disulfide bridges we are having. So any two proteins will never have primary structure. If you take any two proteins, they will not have same primary structure. Okay, one will be M amino acids, another will be N type. So there will be the different types of proteins it is going to present. So we can say primary structure of DNA, it will give sequence of nucleotides. Okay, so what we can say here, primary structure is nothing but what here, it is a sequence, the sequence in which amino acids are arranged in proteins with disulfide bridges. What we can say here, with the disulfide bridges it is going to have. Okay, so but what we can say here, no two means if you have been taken here, no two amino acids will be having. So what we can say here, no two proteins have same primary structures. So this is nothing but primary structure. Okay, so here we can take example of DNA. So DNA will be having sequence order, so the structure of will be DNA. So here what we can say, diribose nucleosides which will be arranged in orderly. Okay, so this is nothing but primary structure. Coming to B, next one we are having secondary structure. So secondary structure is nothing but what here, it is based upon shape of polypeptide. So it will give shape of the polypeptide. So maximum hydrogen bonding between CO group and amino acids will be having, and with another. Here secondary tertiary structures of proteins will be by hydrogen bonds, disulfide bonds, van der Waal, electrostatic attraction force only it is going to take. Steric hindrance is also very less here. Repulsions between like charges it is going to take. So here two types again we are going to have, that is alpha structure and beta structure. Alpha structure is nothing but here what here, alpha structure is like a coil shape, and beta pleated structure is nothing but backbone like it is going to have. Okay, coil formation only we are going to say. So what we can say here, in secondary structures it refers to shape of polypeptide options. It refers to polypeptide chains. Okay, so here maximum hydrogen bonding between CO group of one amino acids and amide group of hydrogen. Okay, so what we can say here, CO group of one amino acid and amide hydrogen of another amino acid, C double bond wo H. okay, so amide hydrogen of another one we can say. So here secondary and tertiary structure of proteins are stabilized by, so what we can say here, secondary and tertiary structure of proteins stabilized by hydrogen bonds, disulfide linkage, van der Waals, and electrostatic attraction, you can say. Okay, so what we can say here secondary and tertiary, so if you have been taken here, secondary and tertiary structure of proteins are established by what here, hydrogen bonds, disulfide linkages, van der Waals, and electrostatic attraction. So here we are having two types, that is protein can be alpha helix structure and beta pleated structure. Okay, so here alpha helix structure is like this we are having, which will be like coil form. So beta pleated structure is like this we are going to have, which will like a shape of the backbone. So these all are will be having the C double bond or NH, okay, in the middle, and also disulfide bridges also it is going to have. So this is about secondary structure. So coming to primary, what I have told you, it is a sequence order. Coming to secondary, what I have told you, it is a alpha pleated structure and also beta pleated structure. Alpha means coil type we are going to have, beta means backbone type structure we are going to have. Okay, so this is nothing but what, secondary structure. Coming to next one, tertiary, we are having, so tertiary structure is nothing but we can say three dimensional structure. So three dimensional folding of proteins we can say, means what here, it consists of both alpha primary structures and secondary structures. So it is having both primary and secondary structures we can say for tertiary. Primary means like this it is going to have, secondary means like this we are having, and coming to tertiary 3D dimensional low. So 3D dimensional means what here, so it is going to have like this. So this is the shape we are having. Okay, so this is about tertiary structure. So means 3D dimensional structure by combination of both primary and secondary structures we are having, or it will be having both fibrous and globular structures we are having. So this is about tertiary. Coming to quaternary, we are having, so quaternary structure. So quaternary structure is nothing but what here, quaternary structure is nothing but it explains arrangement of different protein chains, means subunits it will explain. So what we can say here, it is going to explain what here, it explains arrangement of different protein chains, which we call it as subunits. Okay, so different protein chains it is having, it is only possible in oligomers. Oligomers is nothing but what here? Oligomers is nothing but here it consists of dipeptides, tripeptides, tetrapeptides. Oligomers in the carbohydrates we have studied disaccharides, polysaccharides like that. So here in between protein chains we are having hydrogen bonding, electrostatic attractions, hydrophobic interactions also it is there. So six subunits it is present, that is it consists of mainly three types, that is quaternary structure of hemoglobin is tetrahedron structure. So what we can say here, it is present in oligomers. In between it is present protein chains. In between protein chains what it is present? Hydrogen bonding, electrostatic attractions, hydrophobic interactions, so these are the structures it is going to present. So here it is having what here? Six subunits it is having in quaternary structures. So maybe the arrangement may be three types. So here example we are going to have quaternary structure of hemoglobin. So if you take quaternary structure of hemoglobin is what here? Hemoglobin is tetrahedron we can say. Okay, so these are the quaternary structures. So it is going to have this shape like this. It is combining both tertiary structure and also, so this is the shape of the quaternary structure it is going to have. So this is about the structure of proteins and also protein types. And we are having one more thing, that is denaturation of proteins. Denaturation of proteins. So denaturation of proteins is nothing but what here? Denaturation of proteins is nothing but the process, mainly it is the process which changes the here physical and biological properties of a protein. So denaturation is nothing but what here? The process which changes the physical and biological properties of a protein, we call it as denaturation. So what is denaturation here? Which obeys both physical and also biological properties. So when you take the proteins, it will be having some of the properties. Okay, so what are those properties? It is mainly change in pH only the denaturation occurs. So the denaturation is nothing but what means here, if there is a change in pH, temperature and presence of some salts or certain chemical agent. What is denaturation here? The denaturation is caused by change in pH, temperature, presence of some salts and chemical agents. Because of this only the denaturation is present. Okay, so pH is nothing but what? Concentration of hydrogen. When you change temperature, pH, and also if you change salt and also some chemical agents, the denaturation is going to occur. So here when you're adding detergents, heating and temperature, okay, so these are the things we are going to happen. So it is mainly carried out without affecting the primary structure of prism. It's during denaturation secondary tertiary structures are destroyed except primary structures. So primary structure of protein is not going to destroy. So what we can say here, denaturation is nothing but what here? Denaturation
can be occur only in secondary and tertiary structure, but not disturbing the primary structure. Not disturbing the primary structure. So, because of this, only denaturation is going to happen. So, it may be reversible or irreversible reaction. So, when you take egg white on boiling, so it is a irreversible denaturation. Okay. So, what we can say here, denaturation may be. May be reversible or irreversible, we can say. So, boiling of egg, denaturation may be occurring what here? When coagulation of egg white on boiling is a denaturation of protein, we can say. Irreversible denaturation. So means what here happens here? It may be reversible or irreversible reaction, we can say. And here when you heat it, the egg will boil and yellow will remain. So means what happening here? It is an irreversible process which cannot be reversed again. So those type of things we call it as what? Denaturation. So this is about denaturation. This is about the proteins, information, introduction, types, and also structure proteins and denaturation. In the next class, we can see about the nucleic acid. Thank you.